today on an inbounds. If they, Williams is on ball side, look at the double team on Williams because they like to lob it to him right there. You see, but there it is. Quick strike for Williams. Rick's got it in. Too fast to react. Missouri State by one. Young scrambling for it. It's still three in midcourt. Leonard with it. He'll pull it out. 2 seconds left. Dribbling it away. And how about that? Missouri State wins it. 67-66. A mad scramble at the end. And the Bears claw their way to a win. What a finish.
Well, Missouri State, probably no business winning this game, but they never flinched. Konzo Martin kept it cool on the sidelines. Weems came up big throughout the second half. Watch this inbounds, a double team on Weems. And Doug McDermott goes outside instead of staying between Weems and the basket. Now, Mallett, this was a great move by Konzo Martin, putting Mallett on Young. Changed the defensive outlook, and nobody was able to get to Leonard. Leonard just dribbled it out and threw it in the air.
How about the great hustle by Jermaine Mallett, sprawling for the ball in midcourt, and how about the reaction by Konzo Martin of Missouri State, coming off a terrible loss against Indiana State in the final seconds. They didn't have the lead today until a minute 10 left in the game. That was the first time they were on top all day.
And having said that, nobody hung their head for Missouri State. Nobody started fighting at each other. They stayed with it. Konzo and his staff stayed with it. And you mentioned it, Mallett's hustle at the end of the game. He beat Young to the ball, kept it alive, and Leonard stayed with the play as well. Missouri State just made the plays at the end.
And Missouri State wins it over Creighton, 67-66. For Dan Dockich and our entire ESPN crew, I'm Dave O'Brien. For more information on this game, turn to ESPN.com. The preceding has been an exclusive presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. One heck of an ending. Missouri State claws out a W. Now let's send it back to the studio and our man, Steve Munin.